Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. And in this video, we're gonna begin with our KMP journey. What is KMP? KMP is a platform that we can use to build an app that will execute iOS and Android. So the main concept of KMP is we have to write a shared code base, and this shared code base will be shared for iOS and Android. And if you want to build an iOS application, so for that, we have to write our SwiftUI user interface for iOS. Similarly, for the Android, we will use Jetpack Compose. So this is a very basic overview of our KMP. Now it's time to create our first project and see in action how we can use these things. So for that, first I'm gonna use my Chrome browser. In this, you can simply type Kotlin wizard. Open up the first link. So this is a very basic template, and using this template, you can generate your project. So for me, I'm gonna give the project name Hello KMP. For the project ID, I'm gonna use here com hello KMP. So if you want to build a KMP project, on that case, you can choose do not share UI. If you are using share UI, then on that case, you're gonna build a Compose multi-platform application. But for me, we're gonna build a KMP project, Kotlin multi-platform. There is a large difference between Compose multi-platform and Kotlin multi-platform. So simply select this one, do not share UI, and download a project. So this will give you a zip file. So in the downloads, you can see Hello KMP, and I'm gonna simply extract it. So here we are having Hello KMP. Now it's time to open this folder into our Android Studio. So simply open up your Android Studio, and on the top we are having options. So use option open, go to your download and simply open Hello KMP project. All right, so our sync is completed. So our project structure will look something like this. Now you can change the mode from Android to project and open up your Hello KMP project. In this, we are having a lot of directories. So let's open up the shared module. So this is our shared module that we have discussed in the intro. So in this, we are having three different module: Android main, common main, and iOS main. And on the bottom, we are having build.gradle.kts. So in this, you can add all of your dependency. So let's talk about this Gradle file. So on the top, we are having plugin, and we are having Kotlin block. And in this Kotlin block, we are having all the things that we want to set up this project. And on the bottom, we are having source set. In this source set, we are having common main.dependency. So you can add all of your dependency that you want to use in your common main module. Similarly, for Android main, we are having Android main dependency. And if you want to add something which is specific to your iOS main, on that case, you can use here iOS main.dependency. So if you add any dependency in a common main, so this dependency is only accessible in your common main module. Similarly, for Android main, we are having Android main module. Now it's time to understand the use case of Android main shared module. So suppose you want to write some logic in which you want to use context. So context is only available in Android module. If you want to access context in common main module, it is not available. And due to that reason, we are having Android specific Android main shared module. And for iOS, we are having iOS main shared module. If you want to write iOS specific any logic, you can do that thing in this particular module. So we have already talked about build.gradle.kts and also all of the shared module. On the bottom, we are having a root level build.gradle.kts. All right, so we are done with our build.gradle.kts. Now on the top, we are having specifically our Compose application. So in this, you can see we are having source, we are having common main, we are having Android main. Simply open up the Android main. And when you open the Kotlin one, so you can write all of your Jetpack Compose UI for your Android app in here, in this location. Similarly, for the iOS, we are having iOS app. And in this iOS app, you can write all of your Swift UI. Now, it's time to open this iOS app in our Xcode. So Xcode is an IDE that we can use to write iOS application. Just like we have Android Studio for Android, we are having Xcode for iOS. So now it's time to open up this particular directory in Xcode. So for that, let me minimize this thing. And I'm gonna use Xcode over here. So if you don't have Xcode, you can simply open up your Chrome browser and type Xcode download. Simply select the first link and download your Xcode IDE. Now it's time to go back to our dashboard. So here we are having our dashboard. So in this Xcode, I'm gonna open up my Hello KMP iOS application. So for that, use open existing project and go to download Hello KMP. In this Hello KMP, we are having iOS app. Simply open up your iOS app. Alright, so this is our iOS app. Now in this you can write your Swift user interface, and also in here you can access all of the shared code that we have in our project. So this is our iOS app Swift file. So from here you can begin your Swift UI journey. Alright, so now it's time to execute this application in both platform. So for that you can simply click on here. It will start executing your application in iOS emulator. Alright, so our app is executing. Now when I click to this text, you can see we are having Swift logo. So now it's time to execute the same application in our Android app. So for that, simply sync the project first and execute it. So our app is executing. Now when I click to this button, you can see in here we are having Jetpack Compose logo. So yeah, we are done with our first KMP project. If you like this video, subscribe the channel and also write your comments. Till that, goodbye. We will meet in our next video where we will discuss something new about Kotlin Multiplatform.